What's up, dudes and dudettes? My name's Seth, and today we are going to be starting a series of Firefall, an MMO game that is a third-person shooter and absolutely awesome from what I can tell. Where's the F10? That changes it from that cinematic view. So we skipped character customization because at any point in this game, you can actually just press P to open up your loadout screen, go to the new you screen, and you can change the way that your character looks at any time that you want, which is absolutely awesome. Right now, we're actually playing as a assault character. There are quite a few different styles of character. You can see here, too, when we're in this mode, like in-game, you actually get a little bit of a sneak preview of what it's going to look like, because if you're doing it at the customization when you're starting the game, you don't actually get these fancy little pictures. But either way, very, very cool when I discovered that. As you can see, too, there is eye gear, head gear, and stuff like that. These are actually some of the cash shop items, like you can see right here. This is gonna cost us 45 of the red, whatever it's called. But anyways, discard the modifications, and we will continue onward, go through the tutorial, do one of the starting quests just so you can kind of all get an idea for how the gameplay actually plays out. And, I mean, honestly, it's been a while. Like, I've been wanting to play this game for quite some time, but I only recently ended up getting the game installed and everything like that. And I gotta say, for considering how old this game is, because I remember when this game first came out and I was kind of looking into it, but at the time, it was before I started doing Let's Plays. I didn't have a very good computer and everything like that. So the way it is now, it's like, this game's gorgeous, man. Oh, you need a sprint through. Okay. Start at the starting line and sprint forward. So it's got all the basic controls that you would expect from any type of video game ever. And once we get to the later areas too, it's pretty cool because it actually has, like, here we go, we get our first gun. Now, there's multiple different classes, they all kind of play differently. A lot of this game actually really reminds me of Borderlands as well, which is kind of neat. Fire your primary weapon, right click for an alternative action, which I think, yeah, in this case is actually just aiming down our scope. And here's another fun fact as we go a little bit further, but we actually have our flashlight on automatic, so it's just going to turn on for us. And if you middle mouse click, you can play this entire game in first person or third person. That's awesome, man. The only other game that ended up doing something like that was GTA 5, and that was crazy. So as we're using the assault guy, yeah, we're running low on ammo. Press R to record. R to record. My own sayings are getting the better of me. Press R to reload is what I mean, and you can see, like, we're very, very jittery right now. That's because, you know, as we're playing a little bit further and stuff, we're gonna end up getting, like, more steady aiming and junk like that. And as you can see, first person may end up being a little bit better for some people. Maybe it won't be, I don't know. But the other class that I did end up trying out just to test this game out was the big heavy guy, and he's cool because he's got a machine gun, and it works just like Team Fortress 2, where your right click gets the gun rolling, and then your left click is an attack for it too. So the jumping, everything about this game feels as it's supposed to, which is saying a lot for most MMO games. And now we actually get something very interesting here. A jetpack! This is so cool, man. I absolutely love it. Woo! And as for the assault guy, all the classes are actually different in their balance. So our guy can actually jet up a lot higher than the heavy guy. But the heavy guy's jetpack fuel, like, kind of restores faster than ours does. Ooh, hello armor. They're just trying to tease us at what the armor looks like at the end game, aren't they? Yeah, they probably are. I've seen some other in-game users too, and they've had, like, some really cool stuff. I love the VFX in this game too. Increasing level, of course, just makes you stronger. They're explaining this as if you've never played a video game before, which is a good thing. They're talking about power level is what this game considers, like, your normal gear level and stuff like that. Now, gear eventually does start to break on you, but that only comes into play a little bit after the tutorial area. So right now, we're just gonna go to this dropship, talk to this dude. It's gonna throw us into a loading screen where I'm pretty sure it just throws us into the main world where we go and do our first mission. Now, of course, I'm going to just end up skipping all the yap, yap, yap story stuff because I'm not really that interested in it, just because I'm very much interested in the gameplay itself. I'm sure the story is actually pretty cool from what I've heard from people. They say that it's actually really interesting and stuff, but I honestly don't care, like, really. So, if that's what you came around here for, sorry, folks, because I'm just going to be hanging out and playing this game. So, this is actually neat because a little while later, we can actually use dropships, and they operate the same as it's operating right now to get from point A to point B. There is a bit of fast traveling, but as far as I can tell, I think that's on a little bit of a pay-to-win bracket, so you gotta actually, like, pay money to use fast traveling or something like that. I don't quote me on it because I didn't get that far. There's like three different types of currencies. There's like jewels that you get from selling your basic equipment and stuff. There's credits, which as far as I know is from selling stuff on the market to other players. So maybe it's not cash shop. I'm not sure. And then there's like the red coins, let's call it. I don't know what it is. So unfortunately, it's nighttime right now because this area was daytime the first time I was playing through this game. And it's actually a very beautiful game, like seriously. If you can handle the highest settings, it's great. Now, that said, even though I can handle the highest settings, when I go into town and look in certain areas, I get a little bit of slowdown. But as you can see, too, all these characters are very neat. This game very much reminds me of Phantasy Star, if anybody's ever played any of those games. Very, very cool. I love the fact that it's like a shooter game and you go and get gear and stuff. Ha ha! Oh. Connection failure. So we gotta go and take care of what's actually going on with it. What? Someone friended me? Oh, that was earlier, too. Yeah, that's right. So I might get a little bit of slowdown as well just because of, you know, a little bit of recording issues and stuff like that. Because I was getting slowed down in some of the town areas before recording. And recording makes it take, like, twice as much of your computer's power. So, GG. But I love the fact that this quest right here, like, I'm really looking forward to the late game when they start hitting us with some complex platforming and everything like that. I just think that this is like so cool. Why are we naked? Where's our gun? There it is. Jeez. I love this guy's jetpack too. Seriously. And if we sprint too, they got nice little details to the video effects of our character where you see like if we're not sprinting, we just got our little jump boots going on. But if we're sprinting forward, we actually get a little bit of a jet coming out of our back to kind of further emphasize that we are going faster than humanly possible. Faster than the Flash. But either way, man, so cool. Shut up there. Those people just don't stop talking. So it's very neat. Actually, you know what? It's pretty appropriate that it is nighttime, despite the fact that I would very much prefer if this was daytime. The world also oddly reminds me, like just looking at this area right here, it really reminds me of Sunset Overdrive's graphical style, kind of. The game, of course, like this one right here, has a little bit of cell shading going on, as you can see, which is very, very cool. And when it is daytime, like I'm noticing the nighttime isn't too dark, but it is definitely taking away all of the beautiful, lush color of the environment. Like this whole area right here, the starting area is so sick, man, because it's like this area is like it's got trees that are made of giant seashells, and it's just very alien and very, very cool overall. Like I love the artistic design about this game too, except for these stupid little spiders. Them I could care less about. G is our close range melee attack, or you can swap that out for a grenade a little bit later on as well if we end up running into one. And the melee attack is actually like useful for once, because most games it isn't. Oh, maybe it's not on this guy. Okay. Oh, we're using a shotgun. What gun are we using? Is that a grenade launcher? I gotta take a peek at this. We're using our secondary gun, which is a short barrel. Wait, what? Oh, never mind. There's our assault rifle, and then whatever this gun is. I like this guy even more now. So, yeah, anyway, on the big heavy guy, I didn't know there was that big of a difference. On the big heavy guy, he actually starts with a sledgehammer where he just goes bam, like Thor from Avengers, and it just like blasts all the enemies away. But I'm noticing like this guy's grenade launcher or shotgun or whatever this weapon is extremely powerful, at least for the starting area here, because when I was using, my eye is like so itchy, so excuse me if I keep scratching it. But yeah, this guy's gun is like so powerful. I'm honestly surprised. When we were going through here, like when I was going through here off camera. Oh yeah! This is beautiful. I love this class already. Wow. Because I always like high damage guys. I'm sure that the sniper. Oh, those VFX is beautiful. I'm sure that the sniper would probably end up being like one of the stronger classes, just like Borderlands, but I didn't really feel like aiming down a scope through the entire game. This representation, reputation that it's talking about, this is a reputation with each of the factions in game and the towns. So as you do more quests for this starting town, for example, we're gonna end up getting more rep. As we get more rep, we unlock new things that we can start buying in the store and things like that. Now it actually is telling us She's go away, itchy eye. It's telling us that we ended up gaining our first ability right here. I'm going to be scratching my eye all of this episode. Sorry, everybody. We got Meteor Strike, so leap into the air and smash back down at the Earth. Ooh, I love it. And this game actually has a very intuitive system for drag and dropping stuff. As you end up unlocking different slots, we could actually drag this to slot 2, and then it would change its hotkey right then and there. Ignore those vehicles. We'll get into that later. I'm pretty sure that that's actually got to do with an ability. I think that's got to do with something that we have on our other character. I don't know why it wasn't closing there. And as you can see on the left-hand side of the screen, when we click N, we can show our rewards. So let's actually claim our rewards, which it's telling us the total amount of representation, total amount of reputation and experience that we got just by playing the quest. And then, of course, it's given us $3. And then there's another quest right here. Told us again, give us $36 and a bunch of new legs or something like that. There's also a very, like, this game does a great job trying to keep players addicted because, oh, wait till you see this, this is sick. Because as you're playing through the game, it actually is like, oh, you've played for 15 minutes, here's a reward. Oh, you played for another 15 minutes, here's a reward. And if you play for a solid hour straight, you actually get like a big, beautiful chest reward. So what it's telling us right now, glider pads, which are beautiful, gliding works the same as Super Mario World, where you can actually, like, you can actually, if you're good enough, I'm not that good yet, where you swoop down and then swoop back up, and you can actually gain altitude if you actually get the timing right, but I'm not particularly good at it. Also very much reminds me of Star Fox Trove, but of course these wings actually operate like better than they do in Trove. If you're new to the channel or new to the series, Trove is like the main game that I play on the channel. It's another MMO and it has wings, but not like this, man. Not like this. And right now, because we're at the start of the game, we can only end up launching with those launch pads, like the one that you saw back there, a static one. The game does a good job throwing them all throughout the world and everything like that, but a little bit later, we do actually gain the ability to plant a launch pad anywhere we want. First, there's consumable ones, and then there's also ones that stay in your inventory, and they're on a cooldown, so you could actually glide anywhere you want. Now it's trying to tell us that we just got a bunch more garbage. Yes, please, what is this? Oh, it's a new ability. Now, I love this comparison system. Rather than showing a side-by-side of both of your different abilities, I mean, or both of your different guns, maybe it does that a little bit later, you can just see right here, right now, that this one has a higher power rating, it gives us more attack, it gives us more damage per round, it's got item level 3, everything about it is better than our previous one. Same with these little booties right here as well. Now, as far as I can tell too, I think sometimes you can have gear that's way above your, like, skill level, and you can't really see the way that that looks in your inventory until you're the appropriate level. As far as I can tell, I'm not exactly sure about that. Whoa! That guy teleported away and got all weird. Oh, this is sick. It's beautiful. So now, oh, it's cool. The game does a great job with its mission variety, too. Yeah! Get wrecked, you weird monster thing. Oh, whoa, they're turning into air. Careful, we don't want to eat, like, swallow them up. Oh, I love this guy's gun. I like this class. I like this game, man. Seriously, I am, like, so biased towards this game. Maybe it's because I've been playing, like, other games for so long. Like, it's been a while since I played a game that was this tight. And honestly, for an MMO, I am extremely surprised at what they did with this game. Like, seriously, this is die. This is amazing. I want to use our number one ability too, if we end up getting the chance. So what they're trying to tell us right now, the yip-yapping idiots that don't stop talking, they're actually telling us, yeah, that's a very delayed melee attack, that we're planting bombs on all of these weird things. Yeah! Man, that's a laggy melee attack. That's really weird. Okay, we put bombs all over. Oh, this is cool too. I like this. So when, whoa. I love how he's like, beep, 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 every now and then when you go through stuff at high momentum. So this right here, this is like so cool in the map design, man. Seriously, I love it. This is actually just an air gust tunnel, so that means that you can expect that they're gonna do stuff like this to make things a bit more convenient for climbing vertically. It's very, very rare in the games that I've played, like, to see a map maker that actually takes advantage of the horizontal, or the vertical, I should say, rather than just the horizontal. But anyways, whee! It's a little bit laggy sometimes, but now we are at a point of no return, so very, very cool, man, and I love the fact that they just blatantly say exit on it instead of, you know, trying to be all in roleplay and evil. Hello? What the? Oh, we actually just got our first potion. So the way that this works, similarly to Trove, is that every time you press Q, we're actually going to use a potion. You just have infinite potions. They're just on a cooldown. So they're kind of like meant to save your butt once or twice. This is the area I was talking about where I get a little bit of slowdown because there's a bunch of crafting areas right over here. Take a look at this character just to see what the late game armor looks like. Or the late game gun. It reminds me of, like, Ratchet and Clank guns, man. They're so cool. And over... Get out of here, you beautiful person. Look at that armor. Over here is the marketplace. This, of course, involves, like, some of the cash shop stuff, as well as just selling some of our gear. So you can see right here, we could actually sell this battle frame if we drag and drop. The game actually automatically calculates selling fee, minus two, whatever this is, jewels or credits, which we don't have. Listing fee, minus one. And then the profit we're gonna make is 21. And it also says the cheapest on the market, like it's saying that the average one on the market. So this market is actually very, very intuitive. You can sell stuff very, very quickly. You don't really need to learn that much as you do with some other games out there. Now, I'm just gonna equip this chest piece here, and normally this would have actually probably been an episode, but because this is the first episode of the series, I want to go a little bit longer because I want to show you all the other cool, like the first mount that we end up getting and stuff like that. Because it's very, very beautiful, even though we kind of already have ours right now. And I'm also hoping that it ends up becoming the day. Sorry that it's the nighttime. I hate recording games at nighttime. At least this game isn't too dark, but still, man, whoa, rubber banding. Oh my goodness. And by the way, if you're starting up your game and you're wondering, hey, how come your camera zoomed out and stuff like that? This game actually has some amazing options, man. Seriously, you go over into the options area. Where is it? I think it's in the interface. Nope, not the interface. But good point, just that we can look at all this stuff. Like, here's radio submissions. You can actually drag and drop this anywhere on the screen. You can change the energy bar. The layout of everything is customizable. It's absolutely beautiful. I think it's in the gameplay. Yeah, so in here, they actually have a bunch of settings where you can change your depth of field, or not your depth of field, your field of view for first person, third person, while you're sprinting. Extreme customization to make this game enjoyable for how you want to play it, you know? And as you can see, now it's starting to finally end up becoming a little bit of daytime right here. Of course, all the colors are still a little bit drained out because it is still nighttime, but the area is lighting up. There's some of the big, beautiful seashells up ahead that you ended up seeing, which is gonna take us a while before we get to there. But first, we need to go over here, and we're gonna end up doing a little bit of a quest that's going to give us our first beautiful vehicle. I don't know what quest is pointing us in that direction, but we have to go over here, and we have to defend this weird vehicle, which I wish that we could get vehicles like this. Unfortunately, I don't think we do. I will destroy you with my jetpack rocket launcher thing. Oh, yes! Bring on the pain! Hi-ya! It's so laggy, man. Oh, goodness. I love this, though. The combat's great, man. It's so, like, fun and gratifying. The sound effects are very responsive. And even though we are lagging a little bit, you saw that it operates very, very well, I do gotta say. So it's gonna be really, really cool if we end up getting, like, a bunch of you dudes and dudettes get involved with this series and get involved with this game and stuff. I think that could be awesome for us to just go on raids and everything like that a little bit later on. I'm hoping that this series is gonna be as popular as I want it to be just because I think I'm gonna be entertained with this game for quite some time. Anyway, it's telling us that we got another secondary weapon right here, so we just got a better assault rifle. Turns out the assault rifle is actually this guy's secondary. That's surprising, because I thought that this gun that we're using right now would be his secondary and assault rifle was his main, but I guess not, which is okay anyway, because I like this gun a lot more. Oh, yes! We got our first mount, peeps! Look at this, it's beautiful! Get that garbage off my screen! Get the garbage off my screen! I don't want to exit the vehicle. Get the garbage off my screen, please. Well, anyways, that's another player right there. You can see what his class type is based on the symbol. This is a sniper up here. We can actually drive around, hold the right mouse button so you can get a beautiful scenic angle, and hold space to do the brake. Now, the driving itself, the turning, is one thing that I find particularly difficult because he kind of like slides out of control a little bit. I don't know if that's going to improve as we end up getting better bikes later, but maybe it will. Oh, look at that. I'm screenshotting that because that's beautiful, even if it is the darkness. The day is finally coming. Here comes the color. The water looks amazing too. I love it, man. Seriously, I'm glad that they had the starting area be all tropical and beautiful and watery. You can also drive into places too. Most places you actually can drive into, and I've tested it out. You can run stuff over, and it causes more damage than it does for you to shoot it, which is always awesome, man. It's always great when you can actually run stuff down instead of it just doing absolutely nothing. So this is going to be the last quest that we're going to end up doing for today, where it's going to throw us up top there, and then we're going to be greeted with a boss fight. And this, for the most part, is the furthest I've gotten with this game. I did end up doing quite a few other little things afterwards, just kind of exploration and stuff. And I do got to say, as you're out exploring the world, there's random missions that'll show up and give you, they're like timed missions, and they give you basic rewards and stuff like that. It's so neat, man, the fact that you can actually like explore and be rewarded for exploring. However, of course, you're still going to end up getting most of your rewards from the questing system. And as you can see plainly, I mean, the quests are like so easy to track in this game, which is a very big thing compared to most games nowadays. The other thing too that most video games or MMO games end up doing. Hello, random person. That might not be a player. No, that's not a player. The other thing too that most MMOs keep doing is that whole, you know, click and your game will automatically take you to your quest location. I like the fact that this game doesn't do that because I find that extremely boring. But I like the fact that the waypoint markers are very in your face. You know, it doesn't, like, the breadcrumb trail does not take 5 years to show up graphically or anything. It's just kind of on a pulse system over and over that is very, very easy to keep track of. Die, creatures! I'm getting a lot of lag today. That's probably my Canadian internet. I love the VFX! Let's go and destroy more things. I'm running upstairs. Never mind those other freaky weirdo dudes. Die. Oh, I see. Look, he's so lagged out. He didn't even know he was dead yet. We're that OP. We're that powerful. Yes. So, of course, too, I don't know what that side quest is pointing to, dudes and dudettes. I really, really don't. So as we go a little bit further on in this series, of course, the explanation, like all of the talky-talky stuff, I'm not going to be explaining as much of the core game mechanics because I just want to kind of explain that in today's, like the first episode, and then from there we'll just kind of see what happens, you know, what kind of style ends up generating out. That fire is beautiful! Hey, press X to turn on your flashlight. We leveled up from turning on our flashlight. We got a second ability slot. Yes, please. What is this ability? We still didn't use our meteor yet. Afterburner. Assault ability. Rocket forward with incredible speed at the direction you are facing. That was beautiful. I want to do it again. Let me do it again, please. I still want to see our meteor ability, but we'll test that out on the boss because I don't want to end up getting the cooldown. Oh, that's beautiful. Can we do that in the air? Oh, yes, we can. That's so sick, man. I like this game. I hope everybody else is enjoying the game as much as I am. I know I'm just kind of geeking out, and that's pretty much all I'm doing. But seriously, man, this game is, like, so tight. Like, I'm just so surprised that I completely overlooked this game because all the... We got stuff on our back! You've acquired an improved version of your first ability that you never ended up using. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's right. These abilities actually kind of operate the same as equipment, so they can end up breaking in durability. Now, as far as I know, when things break, it's not like they're gone forever or anything like that. They just go into your inventory, and then, of course, that's it. GG, you can't use it until it's repaired. But the point of repairing, of course, is you don't want to run into that while you're in the middle of battle. Let's use our ability. Whoa, we got to choose where we land. That was kind of a little bit underwhelming. That was still cool, though. And I like the radar, man. Makes things a lot easier when you don't exactly know where things are, because unfortunately for this dynamic lighting right here, you can see... Oh, there's not as much AoE on this ability as I thought. Or this gun, I should say. But yeah, the lighting is, like, so horrible right now. Where we're, like, completely in the dark. That's terrible. Run upstairs, or better yet, drive. Oh, we can't because we're on a little mission. Yeah, certain missions end up locking you out of your abilities. Of course, if we were in the free roam world, we would end up being able to use our bike to get up here in style. Ooh. So yeah, this thing right here as well, we will get into this a little bit later. Just, it unlocks a little bit later, so we'll probably unlock it in episode 2. But you use that to get perks. Now, we don't have any perk slots yet because we have to be level 10, but as you're unlocking slots, you can actually just drag and drop any of these perks into your slots, lock them in, and the way that this works is it's very customizable, so you can kind of customize your class based on the mission, based on, like, your playstyle and stuff like that, which is kind of cool. But I guess where the pay-to-play or pay-to-win comes in is you can't unlock your perks for 24 hours unless you pay money. So if you end up messing up, or say you end up grinding one mission that requires like fast movement speed, and then say you need to swap over to a build that's a little bit more tanky or something like that, then GG, you're not gonna be able to do that unless you end up spending money. Boss time. This so much reminds me of Metal Gear, man. I think that's why, like, I love this game so much, because it just, like, everything about it just makes me very nostalgic. Like, look at this. That is so like Metal Gear.
I got a thing on my face to help me breathe.
And a big machine gun. All right. Had a little bit of a hiccup there. Come over here, you. I'm just going to destroy you, no problem. Rocket meteor jump thing. Okay. If he's going to be using his machine gun, that's fine. You go ahead and keep doing it. Look at this. Look at us wreck him. What's he doing? You know what? I ain't scared of you. I ain't scared of you. What? What just happened? I don't even know what that was. Wow, we are wrecking this guy like crazy, are we not? My goodness. Oh, he's got a little thing up there that, as far as I know, is actually giving him power or something. Ugh. I don't exactly know, but that's okay. We don't really need to know. Look at this guy. Get wrecked, dude. Okay, so that ability seems to be a little bit more based on AoE rather than, like, just landing straight on our target. Blurg. That guy at least looked cool. I want his armor. Can we pull up the reward screen while we're here? In the middle of this cutscene? No, we can't. I don't care, be quiet. Let me go explore stuff. Hello? Ooh, is that us down there? I think it was. Oh no, never mind, who's this? Look at his beautiful armor, man.
We're going to kick chosen butt,
Brayfire. Shh, quiet up there. Shut up, man. You look beautiful, though. I'm gonna stand beside him. Watch this. Say cheese. You suck, I'm out of here. See you later, sucker. What happens now? Wah! That was an instant transmission. So anyway, what it's telling us right now is secure lockers and security keys. So opening a secure locker requires a security key you may purchase from the Red Bean store, which is just their cash shop. The other way that it works too is as you're logging in, what was it? Where is it? Tell us. I don't quite understand. So anyways, what is this? Get this garbage off my screen, man. Cracked security key. Yeah, as you end up gaining different pieces to your secure, like, I think it's like 50 pieces to a security key that you can get without paying, just by daily logins and stuff. And then as you end up getting that, you're going to, what is it trying to tell us to do? Oh! Okay. Whoa! Okay! Give me money and give me a purple item. I want it. So yeah, anyway, you can still end up getting those keys, those cash shop keys, as you're just playing through the game and stuff like that, but of course it's extremely, like, balanced in the, you know, it really wants you to spend money on it instead. Let's actually get our reward right here for our next quest that we already did. More purple stuff. Oh, I see. We already got these from the quest that we just did. This is just telling us about it. Unless it was claiming more stuff. I'm not exactly sure. But let's take a peek. This gun is much better than ours, yes. I know that later on the abilities end up getting particularly cool as well. Now, one last thing before we call it a day, because unfortunately this episode ended up being very, very long. As we end up coming over to the starting area, I think that there's a dude over here somewhere. Yeah, there's like a dude somewhere around here. I think it's that dude right in front of us. And he actually lets us... I think we either rent or get... Like, when you first start the game, you end up getting one of these vouchers. I ended up using my first voucher to get us this rental Cobra. I don't know if it's actually, like, on a time limit or if it means that we actually own it permanently or not. Either way, it's pretty cool, man. So, anyway, let me see. Let's put our vehicle there. See, and then we could have gliders as well, so we could actually jump in the air and activate our wings anytime if we ended up actually getting them. I don't think there's a difference between this rentable one and the other one, so whatever. Is there anything better about any of this gear? Those gloves are definitely better. The guns are a lot worse, and... What's beeping? Hello? Squad invitation. I don't know who Laser Star is, but I'm gonna decline right now. Sorry, person. We're gonna call it here for the first episode, everybody, so I hope that you all enjoyed. I hope you're gonna enjoy this new series as well. As much as I have been, I'm just gonna be messing around and stuff. Looks like that guy was able to change his, Battlefront station. What's this? Oh yeah, I think as you get further up, you can actually unlock different classes and swap to them? Maybe it's that type of game? I'm not exactly sure. Either way, we'll find out in our time. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, do not forget to hadouken the like button for me, share favorite, and subscribe to join Team Pixel Sino, and stay epic, everybody.